Thank you. for the folks watching online, thank you for tuning in. My name is Terrence Pepper. I'm with my fellow commentator, Kenny Ciceron. The score is 9-6 for Millar Edge. We just had a couple of technical difficulties. The score is now 10-7. Just to get y'all up to date, the players stepping on the court today for Millar Edge are the names. Number one, Levi. Number three, Jordan. Number six, Scott. Number seven, Bobby. Number nine, Colleen. Number 10, Tyler. Number 11, Matthew. Number 8, Nahum. Number 13, Jordan. Number 15, Bob. For your Burman Bobcats, we have number 5, Sidehill. Number 7, CJ. Number 8, Andrew. Number 9, Colleen. Number 15, Robin. White and number 3, Boris. So at the moment, let's just talk about yesterday's game. So for yesterday's games, Millar Edge actually won the men's broadcast game and the men's broadcast game. They won both games. Yesterday, and we're just hoping to see something different. What do you think, Kenny?
I think they'll come out there today with more fire, you know, 1,000%. As you can see right now, the crowd is routed up. Energy is here today. So today's gonna be, I feel like today's going to be a different score for sure.
Most definitely. Most definitely. All right. So at the moment, the score is 12-9 for Millar Edge. Burman is looking for something, you know, just something to happen, right? Losing 3-0 can be demoralizing, but you know what? That was their first game of the season.
Yep.
This is technically their second game of the season, and you know what? This is a new club. This is a new team. And definitely takes some getting used to, you know, to some of your teammates and all that, right?
Yep, 1,000%. As you can see right now, it's all about winning the first set, man. Calm down the nerves, and then from there, you could win the second set, third set, or however much set that you need to win the game.
100%. And for your Burman Bobcats, currently on the court right now is number 5, Sahil. Number 7, CJ, who is about to serve right now. Mm-hmm. Number 6, your libero, which is Dwight. Number 15, Robin. Number 19, Hovey. And number 16, Aaron. A quick tidbit, you know, actually coaching our Burman Bobcats today, at least our men Bobcats, is actually Pearson Brewster.
Alumni.
Alumni, yes. Normally it would be Aaron Densmore, who couldn't make it today.
Yep.
For apparent reasons, but Pearson Brewster, who has been on this team before, who knows his in and outs within volleyball, is doing his best to bring victory to this Burman team today.
Yep. Two-sport athlete as well. He's been on the soccer team.
Oh, you know? Most definitely.
So,
you know?
Listen, he got a little experience of what game time actually looks like.
Kenny, did Pearson play futsal with you? Or
no, just soccer, actually.
Just soccer?
Soccer, okay. Soccer and volleyball.
But as you can see, we have a lot of multi-athletes here on this team. Burman is a team. Burman is a school in general that just promotes diversity and, you know, versatility.
100%. Yep.
You know what they say versatility is? It's key.
There you go. Yep.
100%. So here's Millar looking to make something happen. That's a good save by Sahil. Pushed back by Dwight. Looking to set up here. Oh, and that's a good point by Millar Edge.
You got to communicate right there. You communicate. Two men's not diving. Just one man. You know?
100%. Communication. So we're still in the first set for those who are just stepping in. My name is Terrence Prevalon, and right next to me is my color commentator, Kenny Ciceron. The score is 10-16 for Millar Edge. Burman playing its second game of the season right now, looking for its first win. Actually, first win of anything, really, because they lost their last game 3-0, and that's a timeout called by Burman University. Don't go anywhere, folks. We'll be right back.
Mute us. Could you mute us? Sammy, could you mute us?
And we are back. For those tuning in, my name is Terrence Prevalon, and right next to me is my color commentator, Kenny Ciceron. The score is 17-10. We're just coming from a timeout called by Burman, the Burman Bobcats, who are looking to get back into this game right here. We are still in the first set. That's set up by Sahil, blocked by the wall. That's Hovey, number 19, trying to make something happen for the Bobcats here. I think it's important to note that despite all the players playing for Burman University today, we have a couple of injuries and a couple of players sitting out today, including Kyle Bacasso and Jezreel Brown, who are integral parts of this team. You know?
Important. Important part of the team. You know, superstars are what they do. So to lose two key players is definitely damaging.
100%. Kyle Bacasso, who has been on this team for about 3 years now.
Yep.
Jezreel Brown, I believe the same. Jezreel Brown is standing at 6'4".
I guess maybe 6'5". You know?
6'5".
He looks tall.
He's
tall. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. But definitely, not only is he tall, but he's a jumper. He's definitely an athlete. You know?
Athlete.
So that being said, it's not just players missing, but we also have our coach, Aaron Densmore, who has been. You know, heading this program for a while now. And that's a great point by Hovey, number 19. He can definitely jump, too.
That's a superstar right there.
100%.
Superstar.
Very integral to this team. But also, speaking on the case of Coach Densmore, who couldn't be here today, but was there yesterday. Speaking of yesterday, Burman is coming off of a loss, 3-0 to Millar Edge on both teams, definitely. But we're looking to change the momentum today. And that's a point for Burman University here after Millar spikes it out.
Yep.
Serving the ball right now is number 15, Robin. Ball goes up. It's received. Here's the set. And that's the spike right there. Well executed. What do you think, Kenny?
Oh, that was well executed. Good hit by Robin, but unfortunately everything got set up on the opposite side by Millar Edge and got a beautiful spike.
100%. That's well received by Aaron. Set by Sahil. Set over by Brandon, number 21. And that's a point for Burman. The score is 21-13. Burman is looking to get back into it right now. Serving now is Aaron Park, number 16. Set goes through, received by Millar Edge. Millar Edge sets it up. On the right side, that does not go through. Another point for Burman. It's another serve by Aaron Park. And that's a good spike, but just a little too much power there.
You know, that was a very good attempt to block it, too. That definitely messed the shot a little bit. So there's a point, too, that, you know, they jumped up, tried to block the ball, which distracted the shot, you know?
100%. I do believe it changed the trajectory of that shot for sure. Here's Aaron Park looking to make it happen one more time. Serve goes through, received by Millar Edge. That's sent to the left side here. Oh, backhand by Brandon. And that wall.
Good block.
Saves it right there. There's Sahil. Puts it up there. That's Millar Edge with her retaliation. Yeah. You know, yeah, yesterday's game, there was a very interesting chant that was being chanted every time that we had a block by a wall, right?
Really?
It would go, build that wall. Build that wall. Right? Burman has some interesting chants as we have some interesting fans here today.
We do.
and that's saved by Aaron, set by Sahil for Colby. Yep. And that's another point by Burman University. We have some momentum here. I think that
Listen.
Four straight points for Burman.
Then point us to the wall. You know, communication. That's what happens. You know, when you can build a communication, build the wall, you get good stuff out of that for sure.
We're definitely rallying, and you can see Pearson Brewster on the sideline, definitely communicating to his team to put them in great positions of success. And that's another point for Burman University. They're really coming together right now. And you can see the leadership of Cole Diwa, number 7, better known as CJ, which is actually the captain for this Burman University team. Another serve by Aaron Park doesn't go through this time. And that's a point given to Millar Edge. Serving right now for Millar Edge is number 7, Bobby, who's looking to change the tide here. It's a good serve received by Brandon, set by Sahil. That was a good set, and that was a good spike, but I think he touched the net there. Touching the net, I believe that's number 9, Colin, who concedes a point to Berman's team right here.
Yeah.
All right, serving right now is number 19, Hovey. Puts it up. Serve goes through. That's received by that libero right there. And that's out. Burman is coming back into this game after being down, I think, about 10 points.
Yeah, now about 10.
And now it's a two-point game.
Yep. See how hard he hit that ball, man?
Who, Hovey?
Hovey, man. Yeah, holy.
He can. He's an athlete, you know?
He got some power for sure.
100%. Here's Hovey making something happen. Again, here's Hovey Clark. Hovey Clark puts it up. That's a good set by Millar Edge. Received by Hovey. Ball's in play. Puts it back right now. This might be a good rally, folks. And Burman is making things happen right now.
Yep.
They are fired up. One more point, and this is tied. For those tuning in, my name is Terrence Prevalon, and right next to me is Kenny Ciceron, color commentator. Burman is looking to get back into this and looking for their first win of the season. This is their second game of the season, folks. Here's Hovey one more time. Received by the libero. Here's a set. Put on the left side, and that's saved by Hovey, but no, that goes out of bounds right there.
That got some power to it, man.
100%. You know, so the rules state that it's dead at 25, right? No, sorry, it's game point at 25, but you need to win by 2. And I believe it's dead at 30.
Dead at 30.
So whether you win by 1 or 2, it doesn't matter. You know, dead at 30, whoever reaches 31st, that's when the set ends. Here's Millar looking to make something happen. And no, Hovey keeps it in. Set by Aaron Park to Sahil.
Miscommunication there by Millar Edge, which gave us the point, so we'll take it.
100%. Serving for the Burman Bobcats right now is Brandon Weeb. Puts it up, number 21, Circle School. A libero tried to handle that, but he couldn't. And this crowd is on his feet.
Yep. Beautiful serve by Brandon Weeb.
100%. And now we're in the very crucial moments, and Burman has the advantage. They have the momentum here. And there's a timeout called by Millar Edge. Folks, we're just getting started.
Yes, sir.
Don't go nowhere. For those tuning in, my name is Terrence Prevalon, and right next to me is Kenny Ciceron. The score is 22-23. We are in crucial moments of the first set here. That set was by Brandon Weeb throws it up here. And Berman's looking to make things happen, right? The set can be won at 25, and Millar just took the advantage here.
Good try.
Another point for Millar, and they win the set right here.
Yep.
I believe we have a sub in. That is Dwight coming in as they're looking for some defensive purposes right here in order to keep the set alive. Served by Millar Edge, received by Dwight. There's Holy, puts it up. Cole Diwa pushing it back. And that's a set for Sahir, sir. And, oh, too strong. And this first set goes to Millar Edge with a score of 25-23. Great. It was a great set.
Great set.
It was a great set. Any thoughts?
Yeah, we were down, what, double digits at some point. You know, 100%. And then we lost by two, you know. So I think it's important to carry that over to the second set. Just the mental mistakes. If you guys were watching it from the beginning, you know, it was lack of communication.
Right.
Which gave them a good five easy points, you know. So it came back to bite us in the butt. But we're going to start the second set with better communication. Now we got a feel for the game. We just got to start right on the right foot.
Right. No, most definitely. I think Burman right now, we are in a position where, you know, we lost four straight sets, right?
Yep.
The three sets from yesterday,
yep,
which we didn't win anything, right?
Yep.
And now we just lost another set. You have to find it somewhere deep inside of you to turn it around, right?
Yep. Yep.
It's very easy to be stuck in the mud, but, like, you know, nobody's coming to save us.
Yep.
Only
yep.
we can save us, right?
1,000%, man. Philosophers right there, man. Right. Listen, the first set, you guys only lost by two. That set could have went any other way, you
That's
know?
Right.
The first couple points that we had lost two in the beginning of the set, it came back to bite us in the butt. So we just got to start off right, you know? Communication. Knowing where everybody has to be at the center positions, and it'll be okay, you know? That second win any other way. So, for me, that's not a loss, man. We got two more sets to go, you know?
100%, 100%. We can also talk about the Lady Bobcats, who will also be playing in a few minutes, you know, hopefully later than sooner, because, you know, we definitely want to win the next three sets, right? You know,
we will win the next three sets.
I hope so.
Let's hope so for that.
I hope so. But as you can see, some of the Lady Bobcats are actually in the frame right now. That
yep.
is
yep.
Emi, who actually is.
I think she's head captain.
Is she captain of?
I think so.
Lady Bobcats.
I think she should be. You know, I think so.
Most definitely, she does have the leadership aspects and leadership qualities that can definitely translate into captaincy for sure, you know.
Yep.
But it's very important to note to know that her boyfriend actually, Cole Diwa, is actually captain of this team right here.
Superstar.
And as you can see, I don't know if it's too clear, but he's actually communicating to his team that's number 7. You know, just communicating how they can do better for this set and, you know, just get the results that they're looking for.
I actually look forward to the Lady Bobcats game, man, to be honest with you, man.
Most definitely. It is quite an interesting team that we put together this year.
Yep.
A lot of new faces.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of faces that you don't see too much on campus, but, you know, our athletes come in different shapes and sizes, different forms, different faces, right?
Yep.
And that's the beauty of Burman University, right?
Mm-hmm.
In this small school, everybody contributes. Everybody brings to the vibe that this school has, and everybody makes the school what it is, you know?
Yeah.
And my motto is that your university experience is what you make of it.
Yep, 1,000%. Right? You told me that many times, man.
100%. I'm a firm believer in that, you know? And what we make of this game, you know, that's in our hands, you know? That's in our destiny, right?
Yeah.
And for those tuning in, my name is Terrence Prevalon, commentator for you today, and right next to me is Kenny Ciceron. And we are in the second set, and here we go. That is a serve by Sahil. And that's a quick point by Burman University. It seems that talk straight out of the huddle, you know, they're right into it, right? It's good to establish good
foundations.
The way
you start is the way you finish.
That's right.
You know? So that's how we hope that it continues that way.
Here's another set by Sahil. That doesn't go where Millar initially wanted it to go. Here's a set by Aaron Park. Oh, by number 15, Robin. And that was a good spike there.
By number 8.
By number 8. Number 8, Nahum, from Millar Edge, seems to be the tallest player on the court today.
He tall. You tall. Right? Good, probably 6'6", 6'7", maybe 6'8".
Yeah. Yeah, he is tall, definitely. That was a good try by Burman University. I think it's important to note that, like Burman University, Millar Edge, I would like to call them our friendly rivals. You know, our eternal friendly rivals. Right? We've been playing Millar Edge every year in multiple sports.
Yep.
Nonstop. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, if there's a team that will face us every year, it's Millar Edge. Right?
And I appreciate their competitive spirit, man.
100%. And just like Burman University, they're a small school, Christian school also. Yep. So it's faith-based, right?
Yep.
But also, like, you know, they share a lot of their athletes with, you know, multiple sports.
Multiple sports, right?
So a lot of these gentlemen that you see on the court right here, you know what I'm saying, they wear different uniforms, such as basketball or soccer or
futsal
or whatever sports they play at Millar Edge, right? And definitely some of these gentlemen definitely play on their basketball team that we face often, right?
Yeah.
So here's a set from Millar Edge. And Millar with 4 unanswered points right now.
Five, I think.
Yeah, that's the fifth point, right?
Yeah, 5 unanswered.
That's the fifth point. So it seems that all 5 serves by number 8, Nahum, have resulted into points for Millar Edge.
Good hit. Good block as well.
Hovey with the misdirection there. Here's Nahum putting it back, number 8 from Millar Edge. Here's Hovey setting up for Koldiwa. Nice wall right there. There's Millar Edge looking to take the reins here. And that is a point for Millar Edge.
That was a very good exchange, man. Very good exchange.
Very good rally. Definitely what you want to see in a game such as this.
So number 8 is about to serve again. Nahum, I think for the 6th time.
And that's a timeout by Burman University, who's trying to turn things around. For those tuning in and for those watching, don't go nowhere. We'll be right back.
And we are back. Nahum again is about to serve again. Holy, he's been here for a good 6-7 serves. Good hit by Aaron, man. Very good hit. So now we came out of the timeout and we scored a point. So let's just hope that we can stay consistent with it. We can keep the exchange going. So we have number 7, who is about to serve, CJ, the captain. Over. Very good setup by Millar Edge. You just had to build that wall. You have to build that wall. We have number 4 who's about to serve, Jesse. Oh, mental mistake. We'll take the free point.
It was about 7 unanswered points by Millar.
Yep.
But now Burman seems to get back on the board now. And that's points for Millar Edge. At the moment, it seems that Millar has full control of what's going on.
Yep.
But, you know, we are still in the initial beginning stages of
the second set.
And you know what? Even though we talked about this, right? You know, solid foundations and everything, right? But I also believe that volleyball is a game of runs also.
Yeah.
We talk about basketball being a game of runs. Volleyball is definitely a game of runs too, right? Because it's the difference between sports like basketball and soccer, or even hockey, for example, or even football, right? Is that basketball is continuous, right? And you can expect high scoring games, right? With these other sports, scoring is more valuable because it doesn't come as often, right? But volleyball is also a very continuous sport, right?
1,000%.
So that being said, the momentum can change at any point. And once it starts to change, it doesn't, most oftentimes it doesn't just change once, right? It changes multiple times, right? Whereas in soccer, if it's going one way, it's going to go that way for a long time. Hockey, same thing,
same
right?
Same thing, yeah.
Yeah, any thoughts on that?
You just got to flow, man. Volleyball is one of those sports like basketball. You got to let game flow come to you, man. And when it comes to you and you get full advantage, then it's a beautiful thing. So, see, we just score right here, number 19, Hovey.
Yeah, that was a sweet move there.
Finesse. That's what
I call finesse,
it.
You know?
Sweet finesse.
And see, I think what he did there was really important because as a very offensive player such as him, you have to show versatility, right?
1,000%.
They're expecting smash, right? But, you know, you hit him with something sweet like that. You see, he hits hard, man.
He hit too hard. He hit up with head,
man. Oh, my gosh. Hey, but like I said, you know, so he went up strong, right? And then he swung both of his hands. So they're expecting to
smash.
Right? But he just, you know, softly pushed it over the net, and you get a point right there, you know? So. That's very important, right?
And
now they're on their feet when it comes to him, you know?
1,000% alert.
And that's a very good point by Brandon Reed.
Yep.
Brandon is also one of the taller players on this team who also stands at, I believe, 6'3".
Again, he's taller than Jazz?
They're close in height. Brandon's a tall guy. He's a big
tall guy. And big guy. His size makes up for it, too, you know?
One of the taller people here at Burman University.
Good block.
Oh, and here's Burman keeping it alive. Sent back by Cole Diwa, number 7, our captain. And that's a good hit. Was that by number 1?
Levi.
By Levi, yes. Who I believe is going to... I think he's going
10.
To serve.
Number 10 is going to serve.
Number 10.
Tyler.
Number 10, Tyler for Millar Edge.
Yep.
Serving here. I believe this is his first time serving for this set.
Yeah.
Serve goes through. Received by Aaron. And that's a good hit by Cole Diwa. Oh, nice save by Cole Diwa. Set up right there. It's a good save by Hovey. Pushed up. Oh, and very nice. Wow, this rally is something right now. Oh,
that,
no.
That boy is tall,
He is tall.
Holy, he has a reach.
That wingspan is definitely going to come in handy for him for sure. You know? For those tuning in, my name is Terrence Prevlon, and right next to me is my color commentator, Kenny Ciceron. The score is 14-6 for Millar Edge. Burman trying to make something happen, and we do.
The captain.
Cole Diwa.
Comes stop the bleeding, you know?
Definitely.
We need that.
Stopping the bleeding is definitely the term I would have used there for
definitely.
Sure. Because we've been bleeding.
We've been leaking. But hey, listen, like the first set, we were down a couple of points. We came back. Let's just hope that we can do it again, you know?
100%. The score is 14-7 for Millar Edge right here. And now it's 14-8.
14-8.
Burman seems to be catching momentum right now.
Hey, listen, it's all about that. Game of runs like we talked about.
Exactly.
Catching the flow. Right now, we're definitely in the flow.
Right. For those who just stepped in, as you can see on our sideline here, Coach Dennis Moore is not present, but his assistant, Pearson Brewster, who is alumni for Burman University, is coaching this team right here, looking for Burman's first win. And that is another point for Burman University. We are catching fire.
Momentum is still by Millar Edge, and we'll take that.
Right. One thing I must note down, though, is that catching momentum is a good thing, but keeping it going.
Momentum,
right? Because if you look at the last set that we had, we caught momentum at the right times, right?
Yep.
But then I think Miller's coach definitely called a great timeout there, which stopped our momentum, and then they won the last 2 points, which eventually won the set, right?
Yeah.
So we have to keep this momentum going if we want to do something with it.
Yeah.
And as you can see, Miller's coach is fired up here.
Yeah.
You know?
Great hit by number 8, Nahum. Which, you know, caused us to bleed again. But listen, it's only the first point of 3-4 points. So let's stop the bleeding and let's get back into the scoreboard.
100%. Let's talk about the coaches for a second. Oh, wow. And Coach Peters almost got hit by the ball there. So Kevin Peters is the coach for Millar Edge, and we have Pearson Brewster.
Yeah.
You can see the difference in age there, you know?
Yeah.
And experience versus youthful, you know, I guess, you know, youthful, what's the word I'm looking for, Kenny? Just like creativity, I guess, you know what I'm saying? Just
Because he's been here for a long time, yeah. He has the game time situations, you know, so he knows what to say at the right times.
100%. Would you, like, you know, we're just seeing Pearson step into this role, but we can definitely qualify him as a player's coach, you know?
1,000%.
Right?
He knows what to say.
And that's out by Hovey. That was the right idea.
Yeah. We got the point.
Oh, we got the point.
I don't know if you guys seen that, folks, but that exchange was beautiful, going back and forth for a good, 30 seconds, I think?
I think that's the longest rally we've had.
Yeah, tonight.
Tonight, yeah.
Well, afternoon, you know?
Yeah, so, of course. For those joining us on the East Coast, I believe it is about 2 o'clock.
Yeah.
And it's about 12:36 here, Mountain Time. Here's Hovey for Burman University. And see, he's switching up his cadence here.
Yeah, he is.
Oh, it's a good wall by Robin. And that's a point by Millar. But Burman is fighting.
We are.
They're showing more energy the deeper we go into the set.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right, but let's keep talking about the coaches, right?
Yeah.
It's a coaching battle right here.
Yep.
Where your assistant is coaching for Burman today. And then you have a seasoned veteran in Kevin Peters, who's crossing his arms right now, you know? So he's, I don't know if it's because he's stressed or if that's his, you know.
That's his chill mode.
Yeah, he's chilling. Yeah. Right? But you can see he's involved, you know? You can see that he's involved, right?
100%.
So as a younger coach, Kenny, you know, I don't know if you've been in any coaching positions yourself.
No.
But, like, any advice, you know, as a player from, you know, from multiple, you know.
Sports,
right? Yep. You know, what advice do you have for, like, what would you tell your coach if he was in a position like Pearson's?
Like Pearson, listen, as long as you have the players respect you, you have to control the locker room, you know? And I think that when I look at this Burman Bobcat team, they respect Pearson because they know what he's talking about. He's right. Been here, been done that, you know?
Was Pearson captain during his time here?
I think so. He was a barrel, too, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, he was. So, you know, and, you know, there are certain people that you protect on your teams, right? If this is football, where you definitely protect your quarterback, right?
Yep.
If this is soccer, you protect your goalie, right?
Yep.
If this is basketball, you protect your point guard, right?
Yep.
And I think in volleyball, you protect your libero more than anything else.
Right?
But, yeah, so I think the respect is there.
Yep.
And I think, like you said, right, if they respect him in the locker room, then they respect him on the court and they fight for him, right?
Yep. Mm-hmm. Listen, he said the right, like, in the first set, he called a timeout, he said the right things, and they came back swinging, you know? So second set, he did the same thing, and look what happened, you know? We've come back a little bit, we're trying to make it a game, and we're trying, you know? So, he's working right now. What he's saying to the team is working, so I just hope it stays consistent for the rest of the game.
Of course. And that was a great hit by number one, Levi.
Yep.
With much power there.
Power.
And serving right now is number three, Jaden from Millar Edge. That's a good reception. And no, Burman doesn't get that through.
Listen, like, you know when you hit the ball, they hit it with a certain type of technique.
Right.
The way they spin the ball, whatever it is. Man, listen, the way I see that ball spinning in the air, man, it's beautiful.
Right. As you can see, everybody has a signature serve, right?
Yep.
Some people jump for their serve. Some people don't. You know, some people... Oh, that's another point for Millar Edge.
Mental mistakes.
Yeah, a lot of mental mistakes here, but, you know, it's not done. That's a timeout called by Burman.
Yep.
Don't go anywhere, folks. The score is 21-12, but I've seen crazy things happen on this court.
I feel a comeback coming, man. I feel a comeback.
I hope so.
Yep.
We'll be right back.
Yes, sir. And we are back. Time of call from Burman Bobcats. Let's just hope that the timeout they called by Coach Pearson is going to help us to come back, you know, because right now we're down by 9 points. So Yeah, let's do it. Let's do it.
Right.
Yeah, a couple substitutions, actually.
Yeah, I think Coach Pearson is looking to enter Boris Ruzindana. I think that's his first time touching the court today.
Yeah, it is. It is.
Boris actually played a lot last night's game. I think he was their starting libero.
Oh, okay.
I believe that Dwight was stuck in class and couldn't get permission to come.
Possibility.
So I actually don't know the situation, but as you can see, Boris plays. He's playing in the back right now. That's where he's starting.
Yep.
He's playing in the back right now. That's where he's starting. And as you can see, he's in a great position right now. And he's, you know, playing an offensive role also on this team, you know. So it's interesting to note the different, how can I say this, the different skill sets on this team.
That everybody can bring. Yep.
Right?
Yep.
And I'm glad that, you know, he gets a chance to come in. As number 20, Evan, who also gets to see. Oh, no. And, you know, he's just getting his legs.
Good on him. He's cool. You know what I'm saying? Listen, this is set to actually get that done. Because realistically, the set is about to be over. So you got to get his feet wet a little bit. And then when it comes to the third set, he'll come back swinging.
Most definitely. Most definitely. And one more point wins it here for Millar Edge. Burman is in a very bad place right now. And that's a good hit by Boris. Puts it up the net. That's great placement by Levi, number one of Millar Edge. And the score now is 2-0. Burman is at risk of losing this game if they lose the next set.
Listen. Now we lost 5 sets in a row. That's okay. I think the best thing right now is just take it slow. You know, I've heard comebacks. 3-1 comeback from the Cleveland Cavaliers against Golden State Warriors. And I think what's important for us right now is just to get one set under our feet. You get one set, we build a momentum, and then you come back for a second set and a third set, et cetera, right?
100%.
So moving forward, we just got to get one set. Don't worry about the game being over. Just worry about the set that you guys play, that we're about to play right now. If we get that first set under our belt, then we'll be consistent enough to win the second set and third set, you know?
Right.
One point at a time, for sure.
You know, we're just hoping for a Sabbath miracle.
Yo.
Right? We're just...
Is that okay?
Yeah, we're just hoping for a Sabbath miracle.
Yo.
Today for the Burman Bobcats, you know? But Millar, you know, despite us, you know, being a little... partial for Burman, right?
Yeah.
You have to note that Millar has some great athletes on their team, right? And they're actually doing what they need to do in terms of, you know, just winning this game for themselves, right? You know, we can talk about Berman's mistakes all we want, but we have to talk about what Miller is doing well, right?
Yeah.
They're communicating, you know, and they're playing very interesting strategies, you know, like with a lot of fakes, right? You know, misdirections. And just switching up their cadences, right? You know, sometimes they run up to it, sometimes they just stand in front of it, you know?
Yeah.
Like, it's not predictable. It's not predictable volleyball, right?
Yeah.
Right? And their placement. The placement, I think, is the biggest thing for them today.
Mm-hmm.
They're putting the ball in places where they know that Berman's going to have a tough time reaching.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Right? So, you have a lot of, like, versatile players on there.
Yeah.
Players that can set really well, players that jump really high.
Mm-hmm.
Players that offensively that are like, you know, it's more like touch than anything, but also players that play with a lot of power and force, right?
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I think Burman has to find a way to, like, you know, pinpoint who's doing what and then find a way to, you know, match up perfectly.
Yeah, like I said, man, this game has a lot of techniques, placements, all that. And we just got to figure out what they're trying to do, how they're trying to fake us, how they're trying to get some points on us. So I think once you figure that out, man, listen, it'll be a game, you know?
100%. For those now tuning in, my name is Terrence Prevalon, and this is Kenny Ciceron by me. We are just in the phases of the third set we're about to enter right now. The score is 2-0. The first set that we played was 25-23, so a very close set. The second one, I believe, was 25-12, so not as great. But Burman is looking to shift the momentum here.
Yeah. Like I said, one set under the belt. We got one set, we make it a game, right? It's not over until it's over.
It is not over until it's over, folks. And here's Burman stepping up on the court right here. I think on the court we have number 7, CJ, number 15, Robin, number 16, Aaron, number 19, Hovey, number 21, Brandon, and number... Brandon is coming out for Dwight, number 6, and number 5, Sahil.
Yep.
One set, one point.
For
your Millar edge, you have number 15, Josh, number 13, Caden, number 8, Nahum.
Number nine, actually.
Number nine, Colin. Is serving. That's Colin.
And number 11, Matthew.
Definitely. And number 6, Scott. That first point was by Millar. And Millar gets two quick points right there. Yeah. See, Burman, there's not really much room for error.
Mistakes,
right?
No. Like I said, it's all mental mistakes right now. We got put ourselves deep in a hole the first two sets, so I'm hoping that we just learn from it. You know, it's just 2-0. We could easily come back from the 2-0 mark. So let's not hope that they go on a 10-0 run on us, you know?
Right. I don't think you'll get to that point, Kenny. Oh, wow.
Well, it's only 3-0.
Right. But see, that's...
That was demoralizing, though.
Yeah, that was demoralizing because, you know... You can't really. It's unpredictable. You know, yep. You can't really know with stuff like that. You know, it looked like it was gonna hit the net. It just went right over. But that's signs of a good set of a good server. Yeah, actually, you know,
1,000%.
Right. So this might be our first rally here. Oh, and that's a great spike by Millar Edge right there. Four quick points by Millar Edge. Burman is on thin ice right now, and they need something to desperately happen.
Just need one point.
Right, here's Burman looking to make something happen. That's sent over by our liberal, Dwight. And
well,
that was hit, but they touched the net right there, and that Burman gets a break there.
Listen, we needed 1 point. We got the points. So let's just build on it.
100%. So yep. Pearson Brewster is putting it in Aaron Park's hands to get some points right here. Aaron sets it over. Here's Millar looking for the retaliation. Oh, no.
Ah.
That's right behind Sahil. Couldn't necessarily secure it. And I feel like Kevin Peters is happy with what's going on here.
Yeah,
you know?
He's up 2-0.
Right?
Has the momentum.
Technically, he's up 5-0 from yesterday.
Oh, from yesterday. Yeah,
right?
You know.
So
up and 9 in the set, too. So he can't be disappointed at his team right now. So that makes me proud.
And even if Burman were to win 3 straight sets, right, he can still say he went 5-0. He went on a 5-0 run, you know. And he won a game, so
yeah, right? We tied up 1-1,
right? But that's quite an accomplishment, actually, you know.
Yeah,
quite an accomplishment. So the score is now 6-1. For those tuning in, my name is Terrence Prevlon, and right next to me is my color commentator, Kenny Ciceron. We are now in the third set. The score is 0-2, in favor of Millar Edge. Is Burman looking to make something happen? And that's a great wall.
The wall is eight. No, that wall was beautiful.
The Great Wall of Millar.
Listen, we did say the biblical school, man. School of faith. Listen.
You know. But right now, we need a Jericho moment.
We need
to bring that wall down.
Yeah, we need to bring that wall down.
Right.
Well, mental mistake by number 6.
Yep.
We got a point, so let's just use that, the mental mistake they did, and just flip it back on them.
Right. Capitalize, right?
Yep.
Right. So I think this is, so it's interesting to note that the last person that they sent was Aaron Park.
Yep.
Now they're sending Cole Diwa, CJ, our captain.
Yeah, so what happens is, like, it's you have to float through the offense, right?
So
rotation, pretty much, right?
Right. So I think the way they rotated... or at least the way it was set up is that this is exactly how he wants the servers to go. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
In terms of best server to worst server, right?
I'm assuming so.
I'm assuming so.
And I'm also assuming so that Dwight number 6 or Ribeiro doesn't get to serve because he has to make sure that he's there just in case the ball does go over back the net and he could, you know, set it up for everybody.
Exactly. And that's a great block by Hovey. Yes, and he puts that right up. And Burman is on the board here.
Listen, 3 straight points.
Mm-hmm.
Got 3 straight points, and this is what I was talking about, game of runs, right? We got 3 straight points. Momentum is on our side again.
Right.
Let's just bid on it again, you know?
It's a great serve,
you got to keep it going, right?
100%. And look, Burman seems to be having these spurts where they go on little runs, but we just got to keep it going.
Keep it going. Like you said, you got to keep the run going. So 4 straight points.
Ooh. Mental mistake there.
We can't afford these mental mistakes right now, man. We can't.
Right. But I'm encouraging our Bobcats, you know, to just do their best. Because what do you have to lose at this point?
At this point, you just want one set.
You have more to win than more to lose.
1,000%. Good communication right there.
They were in sync right there, right? And as you can see, going to serve right now is number 15, Robin.
Yep.
Oh, interesting serve technique. Oh.
See, it worked.
Yep.
Listen, it worked like the other time. They scored like that. You know, it hit off the net. It starts coming out. It worked, and that's all that matters.
And if you look at Pearson Brewster, his composure right now is absolutely remarkable. You know, he's looking for his first win as acting head coach today. And he's looking for his first set win, you know? And Burman is now tied up.
Listen,
as you can see, he's fired up now.
Game of runs.
It is a game
of
runs.
Let's keep the foot on the gas.
100%. I'm looking at Jezreel Brown right here. He's very engaged, but I know he'd want to play right now.
We definitely use Jezreel Brown on our team right now, but he's hurt, unfortunately.
Right. Kyle Bokassel also is not here.
Oh, man.
Oh, and Burman is making things happen on this end right here.
Wall of Jericho.
Wall of Jericho.
The Wall of Jericho.
100%. This is a good rally.
The Wall of Jericho.
And this is, I believe, our first lead of... Oh, wait. We're waiting for a decision.
He hit it, though.
And
Yep. He hit it. He did hit it. Oh. Wait. Did he?
But, yeah. Yeah, I think the decision goes to Burman, actually.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah.
Looking for another point here. And the great Wall of Millar starts again.
Yeah, but hey, listen, the wall of Burman was working, man. It was working.
Right, it was. Man, this is in these moments you need people like Jezreel Brown.
Yup.
Kyle Bokassel.
Because you could hear a high fly.
100%. You know, but I like to believe that Burman, despite not having these two who do play a great role for this team. That they're still able to, you know, do their best and, you know, hopefully win a set. You know?
Hopefully
win a set, right? So the score is still 10-9. We still have the advantage. Here's Hovey putting it up.
That technique was nice. I don't know how he hit it, but he hit it.
Right, that ball definitely did float. You know? Great reception by Robin. It's a set for Brandon. We just tips it over. Here's Millar looking for something.
Good relay.
Yes, that's it. And that was sweet by Eric Park, but it seems that ball's still in play.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, and Sahil with the no-look. This is a great rally, folks.
Oh, my.
This is a great rally. What's going to happen next? Eric Park pushes it over. Miller's looking to set something up here.
Oh, my.
It's a good spike received by Hovey. Pushed over. Oh, and Aaron unfortunately touched the net, but that was a great rally.
That was entertaining. Longest rally, right?
Yeah, that's the longest one so far, I believe.
Yeah.
You know? And I think we should start timing these, right?
Yep.
Start timing these.
Hey, listen. Okay, I might get on the clock thing on the Apple phone and just see how to do that, you know?
100%. For those tuning in, my name is Terrence Prevlon. We are in the third set. Right next to me is Kenny Cicerone, color commentator. And it's a tie game. Oh. Mm. Powerful hit by Aaron Park, but unfortunately that was
misplacement.
O-U-T.
Out.
Yeah. And here is number 8, Nahum. Swinging the ball forward. Yeah. And,
that was a good placement, too.
Very good placement. Coach of... Millar Edge, Kevin Peters.
He's active right now. He's coaching.
Yeah, he's experienced. I think he's been doing this for double-digit years now, I believe.
Looks like it.
Oh, no. That's not going the right way. But
It's cool. I think, got over the net.
Berman's playing a little strategic here.
Oh. Look finesse.
Wow.
Look finesse.
That was amazing by Sahil.
Oh, wow.
Right,
that was beautiful.
Yeah, you know, definitely highlight reel worthy, you know? Post that on the Instagram, young blood.
Oh, definitely would. I ain't gonna lie. But then the quality's clear, you know, and you can definitely see your face on that.
For sure. And as Sahil, who just made that beautiful thing happen, makes another beautiful thing happen here.
Yep.
And the score's tied up 12-12. This, if this if this doesn't fire up Burman right now, you know what I'm saying? I don't know if anything else will, you know?
Yeah.
This is where they need something to happen right now, you know? That's a good set and a good hit, but Burman gets it out there. All right, looking for another one.
Ooh, ooh,
oh, and they tracked it, but there was nobody there on that side.
Yeah, to save it. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Millar doesn't seem to be playing with the same ferocity. Maybe it's because they have some of their bench on, you know?
Yeah, experimenting stuff right now. You know, so you can see what works, what doesn't work, you know? Sure. But so far it's working, you know? Up by one right now, but...
For sure.
Difficult. This is the time of the game where you got to try some stuff out just to see something. You know, you're up 2-0.
Yeah. See, Burman can't afford to experiment right now.
No, we can't. Yeah. Good save.
Good save. It's a good set for Aaron Park.
Walla Burman.
That's the wall. Millar keeps it in play. Libero puts it up for Cole Diwa looking to push it over. Gets it past. Oh, wow. That was a fake set. Yep. Oh, no. Oh, and we keep it in play here. Here's Robin pushing it over for Aaron Park. Great rally by Burman.
He got it back. He missed the last one. He got this one now. You know, this one is in. You know what I'm saying?
In. I love that. You know? You see, Burman needs to put together a string of, of rallies like that, you know?
Yep.
I think it gets the crowd going. It gets them going. And here's Brandon Weeb pushing it up here. Just gets past the net there. Received by Burman. Oh, no. That's a miscommunication by Millar out there.
Yep.
And I believe we do have the advantage. Burman up by one. See, if we can secure another 2 points like this, I believe that the set is in the bag.
Yeah, I think so too.
Right?
This is where the part of the set where it's a little crucial. You know, 100%. You back into the middle of the set, you know. But if you could go up on like a 5-0 run right now, this would be good for us.
100%. Here's Sahil, pushes it for air and doesn't jump that time. Oh.
We're trading blows right now.
We are trading blows. And one thing to I think Millar's switching their strategy. Instead of sending it to the sides, they're attacking straight from the middle now.
Yeah,
and that's what they've been doing for this.
You got to fill in. Now Burman's back in, so now he can help us. And help
right.
CJ as well.
So I believe that Burman has to find a way to counter that now. Good serve by Millar. Oh, and that's a great tip in by number 15, Robin. It's a lot of play by the net right now. Here's Hovey, pushes it forward. Oh, they switched it up, put it to the side, but everything's going towards the middle now, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know, they seem to be serving a lot to that one side. They seem to be setting a lot to that one side with Aaron Park there.
I feel like
he's definitely going to touch the ball a lot on that side.
You got to save CJ's legs for the crucial part of the set, you know what I'm saying? You got to save Hovey's legs for the part of the end of the set. So, and what he's doing right now is working. You know, you got a couple points for us, so I just hope he can help us get more points.
100%. Here's Millar.
Oh! Wow.
Miller's putting together a string of... And that's a timeout called by Bobcats. This is an important timeout here, folks.
Yep.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Right back. And we are back. We're trailing 16-14. Ball with Millar edge with number 6, Scott. Oh, number 9. My apologies, Colin.
You know, 6 and 9. It depends on your perspective, right?
Yeah.
Right. Millar edge looking to catch the momentum here and coming out of that timeout. It seems as if. And as you can see, the Millar Edge girls are getting ready to step on the court here. Yeah. As I said, it's about to end soon.
Yeah.
Hopefully they don't get to play anytime soon, because, you know, we definitely want to see the Burman Bobcats, you know, rally and just, you know,
get a set at least.
At least a set. Right. I'm not gonna lie, 6-0 is crazy.
You're like, I ain't trying to let that happen, man. For sure.
For sure. Here's Aaron Park, who's back to serving now.
Good serve.
Oh, my. That was a spike. Wow.
He said, hey, listen,
I got
murder
on
no.
my mind. What are we going to take at you?
Hey, listen, I was just going to say, listen, he said, screw the placement. I'm just going to hit it hard as I can.
Oh, definitely. That's pure violence right there.
Hey, listen, like you said, bro, it's mine, you know?
And that's out by Millar Edge.
Good eye by CJ, the captain. Mm-hmm. Good eye.
So we are near the final moments of this set right here. Score is 19-15. Millar Edge Bobcats are trying to get back into it so that they can, you know, potentially come back and win this, you know?
Yeah. I hope we do.
Most definitely. That's received by Aaron Park, set by Sahil for Hovi. And you see, that's the switch up that we're talking about.
That's the finesse that we're talking about. Yep.
Every time he jumps like that, they always expect a big hit, you know?
Heavy hurt.
But he always switches it up, right? You know. And that's an example of a smart volleyball player.
Listen,
right,
he's reading what the cards that are being dealt to him, you know?
Exactly.
Look what happened.
Exactly. You know, you don't force anything. You just take whatever's offered. And that is out.
See, 2 points.
We're going somewhere with this now. You know what I'm saying? Now, Burman has to recognize what phase of the game they're in right now, and mistakes cannot happen.
Nope. You know? Crucial part of the set, like we mentioned.
And here's our captain heading it up there. Millar making something happen. Nahum for Millar Edge denied right there by the wall.
Good save by
Aaron Park. Put up by CJ. And that is great placement right there.
The captain.
Great placement. I don't know if you saw, but he definitely looked at the line before he hit that.
He did.
And he was like, I'm going to put it at the edge of the line, make a choice.
Yep.
Oh, no.
That's what we were talking about, the mental mistakes.
We can't
afford that right now. We can't.
It's okay, though. You know, they need 5 points in order to win the set. We need 7. We're at... Right now, it's 0-0, you know?
Yeah.
It's 0-0 with just a little extra work to do, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, and that's a point for Millar Edge. We are down 3, but we're not in the worst positions, you know?
It's just that we
can't concede at this point.
No, we can't. We can't. We got slow to bleeding down for sure.
Right.
Can't afford mental mistakes. Oh, we for the hit? We'll take that.
That's the great Wall of Burman.
Wall of Burman. Definitely destructed that shot. I'm placing it where I know where he wanted to place it, but the Wall of Burman came through and saved the day.
100%. We are at crucial moments of this set right here, where a team can win it if they win by 2 after 25, but 25. At 30, it's dead.
It's capped.
So here's number 15, Robin, putting it up there. Millar looking for something to happen. It's a set for Holby. Oh, and that's a great Wall of Burman. He is a problem. That's a great Wall of Millar, sorry.
Yeah.
That's
Nahum.
He's a problem. He's a problem,
Wait,
you know?
Did something happen?
I think they're trying to make a decision here.
They call it a technical or something?
I think they're trying to come to a decision here.
I think the ref was about to call it technical.
Okay.
Or maybe she... Yeah.
I think a comment was made.
Yeah, probably. She probably took it to heart. No.
Yeah, but I think she let it slide.
Yeah, she did. She looks like a nice ref. She's been doing her job so far. She's been doing her thing. So shout out to the ref today, man.
Right, of course, yeah. They're making some good calls, you know.
Yep.
Some of the tougher calls, you know, she made them with good insight. And that's a good, crucial point by Hovi.
Listen, I don't know what the ref said to him. I don't know what he said to the ref, but he got mad. And
he
came back with vengeance, you know.
I am
vengeance, you know. Shout out Batman.
Yeah. So... I'm looking at this. Right? That's out.
Listen, we were just talking about this. We stopped the bleeding. We stopped the bleeding.
See, this is do or die right here.
Yep.
This is do or die. And Hovey's going...
Serve again?
To serve right here.
Oh, my. See,
he's coming for blood. I don't know what was said.
I don't know. I am vengeance. That's what he's saying right now. I don't know what was said to him, but listen, he said, okay, bet. I got you.
So is that his new nickname?
Vengeance? It's looking like it today.
Here's vengeance.
Oh, my goodness.
Here's vengeance.
Listen. Vengeance. He's coming. Listen, we need one set. We need one set. Everybody come for this set, you know?
That's a timeout. Wow. Kevin Peters says, I've had enough. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, listen, that's what I call a superstar, man. Taking over the game.
Right.
He sees that we're down two sets. He said, okay, 2018 LeBron James.
We need to make something happen.
Let's make something happen. 100%. I would use volleyball terms, but listen, I'm not, you know, the most.
Yeah. You put two basketball heads behind the mic. What do you expect?
We're doing our best, you know?
We are doing our best, you know? But for those tuning in, my name is Terrence Prevalon. Right next to me is Kenny Ciceron, color commentator. And right now, the score is 23-22.
Yep.
We are down two sets. And as you can see, that's Pearson Brewster, alumni, who is the acting head coach for today in absence of Aaron Densmore, trying to lead his team to victory. The team seems to be ultra-focused right now.
Yep. Like I said, the superstar, Hovey, you know, Vengeance, as I like to call him, he valued it all together, you know, and him scoring 2 points by himself or 4 points by himself has the team rejuvenated.
100%.
You know? He got Princeton rejuvenated, Coach Princeton rejuvenated. So, listen, I know he gave a good pep talk. We need 2 more points to win the set.
Yeah.
Let's just hope that we could, you know, score those 2 points.
100%. You know, that's a great nickname that you gave him.
Vengeance.
Vengeance, you know?
Yeah, I appreciate it.
We got to let the school know.
Yeah, for sure.
We got to let the school know. But yeah, here's Vengeance with another serve. Puts that up. And they're having a hard time receiving those. Oh,
good block though. That's a good block, but it went. Yeah.
So Burman's not in the worst positions here.
Nope.
They just need one stop.
One stop, one point.
Right. If Burman concedes 2 points right away, that's the end.
The end of the game.
There are no more sets. There are no more chances.
No more mental mistakes, man.
Right.
Oh my.
There's something by Aaron Park. Oh, that's a great save by Millar. Great reception. And that's a set for Cole Diwa. Pushes it forward. Oh, that's a great reception. Here's a set by Hovey. Pushes it forward. That's side hill number 5 for Burman Bobcats. And here's Nahum. Oh, and this is a rally, folks. Robin.
Out.
Oh, that's out.
That was a good rally, though.
You know, this is it, folks.
Very good rally.
This is it.
Listen. One stop. Let's bring it to the Deucey, man. That's all we need.
This is it.
This is what we kind of need, but we want a timeout, you know?
This is it.
Come on the nerves.
So that's a serve by Nahum. Received. And here's Vengeance. Pushes it forward.
Yes!
Number 10.
Oh, wow.
A great try. And that is the end. That's the same score as the first set.
Yep.
25-23. And Millar Edge comes out victorious.
3-0.
3-0.
Yep.
Unfortunately for the Burman Bobcats, it was a great game.
The second set was what really messed us up, for sure.
The
first set and third set, we came back. Like I said, mental mistakes, man. The first first three sets, we went down big, and then you know we had to do a little bit more hard work in between those sets, you know.
But as you can see, we're good sportsmen. You know, even though we wanted to win today, as you can see, there's a lot of happy faces.
Number 1 from Miller. Number 19 from Burman.
But yeah, folks.
So number 19, Vengeance.
Yeah,
you know?
Vengeance. Yeah.
Definitely deserves to hear his name called after the end of the game. And number 1, that is Levi.
Yeah.
High jumper too, you know.
Yep.
If it wasn't gonna be Levi, I would have gave it to number 8.
Number 8,
But definitely Levi. I can see why he deserves that.
Yeah,
sure,
yeah,
you know?
Definitely. Timely points.
Yeah, definitely. And if it wasn't gonna be number 19 for Burman, I can definitely see a couple people. Aaron Park.
CJ,
you know. But yeah, you have a couple people who definitely showed out today.
Yeah.
And it was a great game, despite you know, it being very lopsided.
Yeah.
But you know. You know, this is just the beginning, you know, and we can have a great season, folks.
Definitely. Don't go away. The girls are about to play soon in about 15 minutes. So
for sure.
Listen, like, this is going to be an even more exciting game, for sure.
Right. So my name is Terrence Prevalon, and Kenny Ciceron is right next to me. Don't go anywhere, like we said. You know, the girls are about to play. Lady Bobcats definitely looking for their first win today.
Yep.
Coached by Jarrell McMahon.
Yep.
And, yeah, just stick around, and we'll be seeing you soon.
Yep.
visitors Millar Edge against your Burman Bobcats. Introducing Miller's roster, number 3, Nicole, number 4, Katie, number 5, Maddie, number 6, Isla, number 7, Morgan, number 11, Aiden, and for Burman, number 15, Jax, number 5, Evie, number 12, Jacob, number 14, Demisha, number 10, Grace, number 6, Dana.
Testing, testing. We are on. We are live. Welcome back to this, the fusion of the Lady Bobcats, who are now playing Millar Edge women's volleyball team. Mm-hmm. This is going to be an exciting game. My name is Terrence Prevalon, and right next to me is Kenny Ciceron, color commentator.
Yep.
Kenny, yesterday the women's Bobcats, they had a great game, but they ended up losing 0-3, right?
Zero three.
So in favor of Millar Edge, right? Mm-hmm. But what are we expecting today?
It's come more ready, more prepared, more communication, you know. Definitely, I can see this girl's excited, man. So I just hope that they have fun in the process and that we come away with one set, you know, take it one set at a time.
For sure, for sure. Serving right now is Dana Ray. So I'm just going to reiterate our starters for today. We have Dana Ray, number 6, Grace, number 10, Amy, number 5, Jess Sika Matthew, number 15, Donisha Cooper, number 14, and Jada Friedman, number 12. And that's a point by Millar Edge to get this game started.
That was a crazy hit.
That was a good hit. Here's Millar Edge looking to make things happen and, you know, keep the momentum going on for yesterday. This is officially the longest rally we've had so far for the women's team.
Yep.
Ooh, at Libero, we have Kimberly Lange, who just came in for Donisha Cooper.
Yep. Good hit.
Good hit. That's Millar Edge looking to make something happen right now. Oh yeah, this is going on for quite some time now. Jessica Matthew puts it up right over the wall, and lack of communication there. I think everybody saw it coming, but nobody said mine. You know.
Yep. Gotta claim the ball. Gotta claim it.
Right. But this is good. This is good. It's only a 2-0. It's only a 2-0 advantage for Millar.
Three now.
Yes. But you know what? As we were talking about the men's volleyball team, we were talking about setting solid foundations, right?
Mm-hmm.
At the moment, it's not too bad, you know, but you want to stop the bleeding eventually, right?
Yep. Agree to 1,000%. Just take it one serve at a time, man.
One serve at a time, exactly. It's a great return by Dana Ray.
Good block.
Oh, great hit. And that's saved, unfortunately, out.
I can appreciate the effort of Dana Ray for running, trying to chase it out of bounds.
Yeah, Dana Ray definitely chased that down, but couldn't get there. And that was off of Jada Freeman.
Yeah. Yeah, number 4, Katie, who was serving. Mental mistake by her. 3 points for us, so we'll take it.
Yeah, Katie Cookson of Millar Edge. That was her serving right there. And at the moment, I believe that is Jessica Matthew. No?
Yeah, Jessica Matthew, who is serving for us right now.
Jessica Matthew is quite integral to this Lady Bobcats team. She's actually alumni of Burman University as a recent of this year, right?
Yep.
Graduated last year.
Yep.
Oh, wow. Tough hit.
That was beautiful. Who was that? Number 15? Number 11, I think that's what it was.
I believe number 11, Peyton Reamer.
Captain.
Yes. Captain of Millar Edge team. It's a great serve. Received by Jessica Matthews. Set by Dana Ray. And hit by Amy Magadaro. Amy Magadaro is looking to get position back. Yes, she does get it back there. As a set for her again.
Oh, nice.
Good tip. There's Millar on the retaliation, and that's good great placement right there. You know, yep. For a second I thought that was going out, but she knew exactly what she was doing on that one.
She did. I thought it was going out two times. I'm not gonna lie.
Right, but it seems that the Lady Bobcats are a little shaken by what's going on with Millar here. But you know what? I feel quite confident that they can turn it around at any time right here.
They're only done by five, man. That's nothing. Man.
Right. All right. That's a great return by Jessica Matthews, set up by Danaray.
Let's go. That's the mistakes. We'll take those.
The wall right here. And coming into the game, that is number 10, Grace Feldberg.
And number 14 as well, Donisha Cooper for your Lady Bobcats.
Yes. Oh. It seems that it's a change of strategy by Jerrell McNames right here. To bring in Donisha Cooper and Grace Feldberg, I think we're going for a wall strategy here.
We're going for height rather.
So more of a defensive mindset here than an offensive mindset.
Yeah, right? I agree.
All right, just to stop the bleeding and hopefully make them make some substitutions.
Yeah, 1,000%.
Right, as you see, their liberals out.
Yeah, well, both liberals are out for both teams. So.
Oh. See, she tracked it down, but the technique was...
Bad hands.
Yeah,
bad hands.
Definitely. She'll make it up, though.
Mm-hmm. Number six, serving Kayla.
Lusink.
Yeah.
Kayla Lusink.
Sounds like that.
Good try, though. That was a very good attempt. You know, so I think
at her name or at the serve?
Oh, your name. Her name, you know. Listen.
Well, you know, great attempt both ways, right?
Both ways indeed.
Here's it. Oh, that's a great serve by Jada Freeman.
Yeah, very good serve.
Oh, they're rallying here. This is a good.
Good try.
What exactly was the point there for? If anything, I saw her hit the net. I did see Millar touch the net there.
I think so, but I don't know.
Oh, was it because it was a float?
Most likely. You know, we're not really volleyball people, but we try, you know? But I think so.
All right. Great reception by Jessica Matthew. This is good set. Good hit by Amy Magadaro. Good hit by number five, Maddie Botker. My apologies if I'm butchering anybody's name.
I think you're doing a good job, Terrence.
Thank you, Kenny.
That's a timeout
called by Jerrell McMahon's, trying to rally his troops.
Yep.
His Lady Bobcats. The score is 10-3 in favor for Millar Edge versus the Lady Bobcats. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. We are back. The Lady Bobcats are trying to find a way to get back into this one. Millar Edge came into Lacombe looking for wins, and honestly, they're on a hot streak right now. The men's for Millar Edge are on a 6-0 streak in terms of sets, and won their last two games, one from yesterday and one earlier today. And it seems that, you know, the women's Edge team is also to a great start, leading 10-3 still in this first set. And that's a great serve right there. Here's a set for Amy Magadaro. Falls. Yeah, she didn't get her feet set right there.
No.
Score is 11-3. My name is Terrence Prevlon, and right next to me is Kenny Ciceron, color commentator. We are here witnessing Millar Edge currently up by a 7-point lead as that serve goes OUT out. Serving for your Lady Bobcats now is Emi Magadaro, number 5. It's good technique, but a little too much power.
Too much power. Yep.
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 Number 5 for your middle edge, Maddie.
Yeah, Maddie Bakker.
Yeah,
Maddie Bakker with the serve here, and Lady Bobcats control that one fairly well. Oh, you guys, great trickery by Katie Cookson. With a great set and a great hit. Here's Jessica Matt. Unfortunately, yeah.
Good relay, right?
Yeah. You know, Jessica Matt, you know, she hit that, but and I promise you, if it went over the net, that would have been a point right there.
Yeah, it doesn't damage for sure.
It just didn't clear, you know?
Yeah.
It's another serve by Maddie Bakker. Set for Jessica Matthew. That's received well. Oh, there's Jada Freeman with that one right there. Dana Ray just puts that one out there. That's a powerful hit, but
yeah, out.
But that is OUT out.
Out.
Seems like we have a couple substitutions here.
Yep.
I believe that is Grace Felberg coming in and serving now for your Lady Bobcats is Donisha Cooper. She throws that straight up. See, last game we were talking about different serve techniques, right? And I just realized, you know, Donisha Cooper doesn't jump when she serves, you know?
No.
She doesn't jump. And that's what seems to be working for her. Didn't work that time.
Didn't work that time, yeah.
But it's interesting, you know, because I think seeing different serves kind of dictates how you place yourself.
Yep, yep.
Right? Oh.
That was good.
It's good wall technique by Millar Edge. That's a great setup for Millar Edge there. Another set for Jessica Matthew with the finesse there.
We gotta pass it better, man.
And here's a set for number 11, Peyton Reamer. That one doesn't go through. Another set for Peyton Reamer. And she gets it to go this time.
The captain.
Yep.
The captain coming through.
Captain, my captain, lead us to victory.
Indeed.
The score is now 15-5. This is a little lopsided here in the first set, but, you know, it's not about how you start, but it's about how you finish.
1,000% with you.
Right? Great serve by Millar. Saved by the libero and on botch possession here.
Yeah.
Millar Edge seems to be handling business so far.
Yeah, yeah.
Great reception by Jada Freeman. And that is Jessica Matthew with finesse right there just to put it over. It's not, you know, it's not over till it's over, right?
Yeah, yeah.
It's not over till it's over. Right now, rules stipulate that you need to reach 25 and win by 2 in order to win the set, right?
Yeah, yeah.
But currently, it is 16-6. And if ever Burman were to come back into this and make it a close game, oh, that's a great hit.
There you go. Listen, I love the energy in the building right now, man. I love it.
I love it, too. It's a great hit by Jada Freeman. But like I was saying earlier, it would be dead at 30. Dead at 30 meaning that first team to get to 30, if both teams manage to reach 25 and it's not a win by 2, wins, right? So if whatever team gets to 30 first, they win.
You're coming.
Right? Burman seems to be shifting the tide here. And let's just hope that they can keep it going, right? Remember what I said? It's not about how you start, but it's about how you finish.
How you finish, indeed.
Definitely. Here's another serve by Dana Ray, who doesn't jump also, but she kind of leans back, you know? I think, you know, people serving. That was in.
The captain again. Yeah. Peyton.
Peyton Reamer. So serving now is number 4, Katie Cookson. That was a great attempt by Kimberly Longshore, liberal, wearing number 26 black. Couldn't get there on time. Here is Katie Cookson, who also doesn't jump, you know, so that's 3 straight servers.
No jump.
No jump, yeah. Great return by Dana Ray. She retreats.
Oh.
And that's a great stand by the Lady Bobcats.
Yep. I made the mental mistake, man. Better for us.
Right. Still fighting to stay in this game. And here we have Jessica Matthew ready to serve. She puts that over. Oh, that's a great serve. Now Berman's in a great position now to make something happen. Oh, here's Emi Magadaro. Flips that one over. Uh-oh.
I could appreciate the hustle, man.
Yeah, that's good hustle. But, see, that was great placement by Millar Edge right there. So, going to serve is number 11, I believe, Peyton Reamer.
Yep. Look, captain, for your Millar Edge.
Here's Peyton Reamer, who jumps this time. All right. I think Kimberly Lunds tracked that one down, but like I said, mental mistake.
Mental mistake. She really couldn't get her hands on it.
100%.
It's okay.
That's fine. You know, these are the sets. These first sets are important sets, right? Because even if you do concede, you see what you're doing right and you see what you're doing wrong, right?
Yep.
So whether Burman loses or wins this set right here, at least they'll know how to dictate.
Wow, that was beautiful.
For the later sets, right?
That was a good strike, man.
100%. That was a good hit. And that's a timeout called by the Lady Bobcats.
Yep.
Just trying to find their way here.
Yeah, it's the first couple of sets. First couple of hits of the first set. But like you said, you know, try to find legs under you, you know, and set the foundation for what is to be. The game's not over yet. You know, if we win this set, it's good for us. We lose it, we got two other sets to look forward to.
100%. And as you can see on the bench there, we have Jarrell McMaines as coach. But the really animated one is actually Hovey Clark, who was announced player of the game of the men's Bobcat game just earlier, who was assistant coach for this Lady Bobcats team. I just think it's interesting to note how much of a community Burman University is, right?
Yeah.
Did you know that Hovey Clark is actually a PAA alumni?
Yeah, I did.
Parkview Events Academy alumni, right?
Yeah.
It's just very interesting to note, for sure. And right next to us, I actually have the captain of this men's Bobcats team.
Yeah.
Can I put him on the mic?
I think we should, man.
Shout out to number five, Emi Magdadaro.
That was actually Cole Diwa, number seven, our captain for the men's Bobcats team, giving a shout out to his girlfriend, number five.
Number five
of the Lady Bobcats team.
Yep.
Oh, love.
I love love, man.
I love love too, man. All right. And we're back into the action now.
Oh, my God.
And that was a great serve.
The captain again, man.
That was a great serve by Peyton Reamer, who, honestly, she picked her spot.
Yeah, she did. It was an empty spot from what I could see.
See, Jessica Matthew, great player, but... Jessica Matthew is a great player, but, you know, when you're tall like that, it's harder to dive on the floor. So that means if you aim it high... You know, it's easier for taller players to get it, right? But if you aim it low for the taller player, they have to reach, right?
Yep. Reach. Another great hit by Millar Edge.
So Millar seems to going to take this one here.
Yeah.
Unless some miracle of God happens here.
I believe in God, so I believe like I can do what he got to do, you know?
He can. But whatever his will is, we'll take it.
We'll take it. Yeah, he knows what's good for us and what's not, you know?
So here is Peyton Reamer serving for Millar Edge. Trying to end the set right here. Oh, great serve.
And she does.
Great serve. Just cleared the net.
Yep.
And that's the end of the first set there.
Yep.
25-9. Those who are just tuning in, my name is Terrence Prevalon, Kenny Cicerone right next to me, color commentator. That is... a score of 25-9, Millar Edge wins versus the Lady Bobcats. Don't go anywhere, folks. We're just getting started.
Yes, sir.
Welcome back. My name is Terrence Prevlon, and right next to me is Kenny Cicerone, color commentator. We are about to get started with the second set for this women's volleyball game.
Yep.
The Lady Bobcats lost their last set and are on a 4-0 losing streak.
Yeah, set-wise.
Set-wise, of course. From yesterday, they lost three sets.
Yeah.
And won none. But they're looking for their first set win and hopefully first win today of their season, right? So this is the second game of their season.
Yeah.
And Millar's off to a hard start. You know, not just the women's, but the men's too.
Yeah. The captain from Millar Edge, she's been doing her thing. So I think we just got to slow down the bleeding, communicate, and we'll be right back in it, man. A lot of mental mistakes in the first set.
So. 100%. So we're off to a pretty good rally here. It's a great hit.
That's a tough one. That's a tough one. Number three is going to serve a Nicole
Hamm.
Yeah.
Nicole Hamm serves it. Here's a set by Dana Ray, pushed forward by number 12, the Lady Bobcats.
Good defense.
And that's pushed forward. Oh, that's a great hit, and that is out.
Out. I will say we gotta set up Jessica a little bit more, man. Set up our strikers, man, because I don't see so much of that in the first set.
Set up your ace for sure.
Yeah, so we gotta set her up and then try to see if she gets some strikes down, and some hits down, because I haven't seen too much of it. That's a mistake.
The score is 2-1 for Millar Edge Women's versus Lady Bobcats. Set up for Emi Magadaro.
Good hit.
Oh, good hit. I see what Ebony Budd was going there for, but she couldn't get it over there.
Didn't achieve it.
Right. Ebony Budd seeing her first action tonight, or at least this afternoon, for the Millar Edge girls. Here. Coming in right now is Donisha Cooper. Oh, see, that's that dangerous serve right there. Cooper, making her presence felt right away. Also, that serve was by number 10, Grace Felberg, who made things a little difficult for Millar Edge women right there.
Yeah.
And you know what? This is important to note. This is our first lead for the Lady Bobcats.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
Let's just hope that we can hold on to it.
I believe we will.
That's an underhand serve by Grace Felberg right there. Good hit. Oh, jumping right over the wall there. Donisha Cooper with the great return. Oh, bodies bumping into each other.
Yeah, yeah.
Great return by Emi Magdaro. My apologies.
Good relay, man. Good. You know what it is, relay?
Yeah, relay.
Yeah, good relay, man. Very good.
And that's a point for Millar Edge women.
So here you have number 26 for your Burman Bobcats, substituting for number 10. So number 26, Kim coming in for.
That is a libero.
Yeah.
Coming in for, I believe, Grace Felberg.
Grace Felberg. Thank you very much. Now it's tight. Oh, we're up.
Yes, that's a point for the Burman Lady Bobcats.
Yep.
Here's a serve by Jada Freeman. Oh, right in her chest.
Yep.
Right in her chest.
Too much pop to it.
Oh, definitely. Too much pop to it. Definitely. I don't know what was said in that huddle, once we switched sides, but it seems that the Lady Bobcats are playing with a little more confidence, a lot smarter. And let's just hope that this can keep going, right?
Yep.
And honestly, Jada Freeman is pinpointing her spot. She's going left, right.
Just always plays with energy, man. Always plays with energy.
Definitely. She's surgically finding these, weak spots.
Yep.
Against the Millar Edge team right here. And it's a 7-3 lead.
with too much power.
I think she went for the same spot again, but they let her go this time. It's a 7-4 advantage. Hitting now for Millar Edge. Ebony Bud just makes it past the net there. Here's a set by Dana Ray to Ina Nagadara.
Wow.
Wow. And you know what? To get it over the wall at her stature, you know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Yeah, she had to put a lot of power into there.
And she did.
And she did, right?
And it worked.
Now she gets rewarded and gets to keep the momentum going by getting a serve herself. Here's Ina Nagadara. Puts it up, jumps, gets it right past, and that's a beautiful serve.
Hot streak right now.
Oh, yeah,
man.
She's fired up.
You're fired up right now. 10-4 is the score, right?
10-4 is it's 9-4, I believe. I don't know if we got a point for that. I don't think so. Right, so. Oh, yeah, she's aiming low. Yep. She's making them work for it.
She has to. Good dive.
Good dive by Kimberly Lunch. Right. Hey, she got some hops to her.
Yep.
I didn't quite see who that was. I believe that was number 9. No, there's no number 9. Sorry. That's either number 8, Kennedy Rome, or number 10, Taylor Williams. It's a good hit by number 11, Peyton Reamer. Oh, a good dive. It's a set. And that is O-U-T.
Yeah, out.
The score is 10-5 for the Lady Bobcats, and honestly, this is what you love to see, right?
A good,
comfortable lead.
Yep.
We don't want to get too comfortable now, right?
Yep.
This is the time to steal things and really make them think about what their next move is. Oh, no, that's a bad serve.
Front of the line.
Yeah, she passed the line there.
We're playing way more comfortable in the second set, way more relaxed.
Definitely. We're playing our game.
Yep. Controlling the tempo.
100%. Here's a hit for Millar Edge. And that's sent back by Grace Felberg. Great dive by Reamer. And that is O-U-T.
Yeah, out. You have number 6 serving. Denare. Very good serve. Oh. Listen, we'll take these points, man. Mental mistakes.
We'll take anything. We'll take anything.
Those. Thank you, Millar Edge. Good hit by Denner, right?
You know, I haven't seen much. Oh no.
That's a mistake.
I haven't seen much decoys in terms of this game.
Mm-hmm.
You know, for the folks at home that don't know what a decoy is, basically it's sending somebody to the net, right? And then it seems as if they're going to receive the ball.
Yeah.
But they're not, right? So,
yep.
You know, you actually send it the opposite way.
Like a pump fake.
Or somebody that comes in, like, in a delay, right?
Yeah.
So one person goes, and then you think the ball's going to them, but then it actually goes to the next person running, right?
So, just like right there, that was a decoy.
Yeah, that was actually a decoy right there, you know? But I haven't seen much decoys from either team, from either Millar Edge or the Our Lady Bobcats, you know? But definitely, I think that definitely helped them on that last
definitely.
On the last rally right there.
Pump fake some of us off, some of our players. Oh, tough hit, very tough hit by Millar Edge. I will say, though, when Millar Edge do come to Burman, their friends and parents and stuff like that do come and support them, and I want to give a shout out to them, too. Man.
100%. I don't think there's any school or any program that comes here that takes their fans with them like this.
Yeah.
Millar Edge, shout out to y'all.
Yeah, 1,000%. Mind you, from Saskatchewan, too.
Right, driving all the way here to look home.
Yep. Oh, good dive. Oh,
yep, good dive. She's back on her feet now.
Yeah, she good.
There's Millar.
Out. Good job. Way to call it.
And as you can hear, our fans are getting slowly fired up.
Yep. Ah, Mental mistake. Mental mistake, man. Cool. We get it back on the next one. You have number 8 serving the ball. Taylor. Good save. Over. Decoy. For good block.
Good. Seems that Millar Edge is, despite being down, they're fighting.
Yo, they are.
And we see a stark contrast to like what was happening last game to what's happening this game. It's the tone has changed.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
The composure of both teams have changed.
Oh,
that's a great hit by Emi Magdal.
Ouch.
So yeah. You know, I think I jinxed something. I think yes, because I was saying earlier that there wasn't much decoy action, but now we're seeing decoy action almost every, right. Yeah, you know. Grace Feldberg with that serve.
Decoy
again. Definitely, yeah, but I didn't work out. But see, if I'm decoying, right, why is my libero coming up?
Mm.
Right?
Yo.
I need my libero in there for defensive purposes. Unless my libero is like the LeBron James of volleyball. I don't know who that is, you know what I'm saying? But yes.
I ain't never been a LeBron James of volleyball, man. I could do everything.
Huh?
I wouldn't know.
And it might be Jessica Matthew, you know?
And look, it's looking like it. It's looking like it.
And
oh,
that's
time
a timeout. You know, this is what we love to see, right? Let's see the change of tides here. And happy smiles and happy faces and happy composure on that Burman sideline there.
Yep.
We'll be right back in 50 seconds, folks. Back, the Lady Bobcats are honestly on a hot streak right here, looking to steal this set away here from Millar Edge. Lady team.
We have number 10.
That's Grace Feldberg with the serve right
here. Yep. Oh, good little serve. Ooh,
great
good
hit.
Block. Good try. Good block attempt.
Serving now for Millar Edge is number 14, Ashley Volkman. Doesn't get it across here. And Burman is in a great position now. We can actually steal this set right here.
Yeah. We need this.
Here's Jada Freeman, who's honestly, her serve's been dangerous today.
Dangerous.
Oh, that's
good
a
save.
Okay.
Good hit. Weird angle, but it went through.
Uh-oh.
Let's go.
Uh-oh.
Listen.
They're hot now.
There we coming.
They're hot now. And here's Jada Freeman. Looking to do some damage. Great serve. It's a set.
Ooh.
Honestly.
That's the finesse. Good relay.
This is good. Here's Emi Magdal. Honestly, Emi Magdal is making these middle blockers and outside hitters work for their money right here. Here she goes again.
Oh,
yeah.
We coming, folks.
Wow.
You coming, folks.
See, those opposite hitters and those outside hitters and those middle blockers, when they see her, you know, they fear her.
Yep.
Like, she's slowly making them, you know, start to think about some decisions they make.
Yep,
right?
yep.
Oh, wow.
Would you look at this, folks?
Would you look at this?
Like Deion Sanders says, we coming.
You know what, Kenny? We here.
We here. I'm sorry, we here, you know?
You know? Only 4 more points needed, 10 to set right here. Great serve.
Good low serve.
Oh, yeah. Oh, no. That's a mental mistake right there by Donisha Cooper.
She couldn't get low enough to get that ball.
It's okay. It's okay. You know what? Even though we're comfortable where we're at, we don't want to be too comfortable, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Like we said earlier, it's a game of runs. This is a serve by Ebony Budd, number 2 of Millar Edge. Got to put that away now. Kimberly Lodge clears it. That's a set by Budd.
Good block.
Block by Donisha Cooper. Here's a set for Amy McDowell, and that is out.
She fell. Good. Good fake.
Millar Edge looking to make something happen here and stop the bleeding. Oh, and that's a great clearance by Kimberly Lawrence, but unfortunately the trajectory is not in her favor. That goes out. You know, Millar Edge here refusing to die. Well, metaphorically.
Ooh.
Good hit by Eden Maddow.
That was low. I love it.
Great set by
good
Budd.
Finesse.
Good reception.
Good job, Donisha.
Good clearance by Donisha Cooper.
Where is still where?
Donisha Cooper tries it one more time. Just couldn't get it over the net. That's a timeout. Joel McMahon's not happy.
Nope.
Not
but
happy.
It was good relay, though.
Yes. But, you know, as a coach, I wouldn't be happy either because, you know, we're in the driving seat.
Yeah.
Right? We're up by almost double digits, and now we cut that down by half, right?
Yeah.
At this point of the game, you know, you want to just be in control of your own destiny, right?
Yeah.
But we'll be right back, folks.
Yep.
Welcome back, folks. For those who are tuning in, my name is Terrence Prevlon, and right next to me is Kenny Ciceron. Here we are on the way in the final stages of this
second set
right here. Oof. And Millar Edge is coming back after, you know, a flurry of points by our Lady Bobcats. And serving right now is Budd for the Millar Edge. Wow.
Oh, man.
Powerful by Peyton Raymer.
The captain.
So, Millar Edge is closing the gap on what used to be a stout lead, but now it's looking like a close game here. There's another save by Ebony Budd. Oh, no. Seems like a monumental collapse by the Lady Bobcats here.
We can't afford these mental mistakes, man. These surgical mistakes. We can't afford them. We need one under our belt for us to feel comfortable. So let's go.
Of course. There's another serve by Ebony Budd. It's a set by Dana Ray. Up 4. Lady Bobcats looking to make something happen now. And that is out. You know, at this point, you know, what do you do? What do you do? What do you do to keep the lead that you built?
Right? Yeah, yeah. At this point, listen, you just got to stay composed. Stay composed. These mental mistakes, still win the game.
And that's tied up. I think what needs to happen is they need to compose themselves and just find it, you know, just find it within themselves to get the results that they want, which is a win, right? At this point, there's no room for error. And I don't think that the Lady Bobcats can afford to lose this next set right here. It's served by Ebony Bud. And that is another point conceded to Millar Edge. Millar, shout out to Millar Edge, though, you know what I'm saying? They were down almost by 10 points, if not by 10 points, and found their way back into this game. Now have the lead. Here's another serve by Ebony Bud, who's been there for a minute now, you know?
Yeah.
Set by Dana Ray, hit by Danisha Cooper, gets blocked by the wall.
Oh, Millar wall.
And Millar is just rallying here, coming to life after that flurry of points by Burman, but it seems to be a collapse here. And Miller's definitely taking advantage. And that is out. That is out by Ebony Bud, who's been serving for quite a while now, you know, but now there seems to be a switch. And right now is Emi Magadaro, who's looking to seal the deal for the Lady Bobcats. Gets it over, and that is out. Oh, no.
Mental mistake.
It's these mental mistakes that we're talking about, right? One more point, and that's it.
Just got to stay composed.
Yeah, okay. Here's Rainer.
Good. I'll take that. Thank you very much.
Yep. And now Burman is in a great position here. Here's Donisha Cooper, who hasn't had the best serves today.
I think she's 1-for-2.
Yeah. Actually, she's 1-for-3, I believe.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Well, there you go.
Good.
Yeah, that's good. Wow, that was Burman's chance right there, and unfortunately they lose the set 25-23. You know what, like, it seemed that they were going to turn it around last minute, but Millar Edge clutched up and they made it happen, you know what I'm saying? They did it. They made the comeback come through. So now, as they're going to the bench and as they confer and talk about what needs to happen, if you were the coach on that sideline, Kenny, what would you say to the Lady Bobcats?
Like I said to the other guys in the last game, you know, we got to take it set by set. Just get one set under your belt, and you'll be okay to keep pushing for the second set, third set, fourth set, et cetera, right? Like we've seen in this set, you know, we didn't start off the best way, but in the middle set, when it was crucial, we bit up a lead and we blew it, right? So I think it's just taking it serve by serve, relay by relay, and then from there, we're trying to win the set, you know?
Sounds good. My name is Terrence Prevlon, and right next to me is Kenny Ciceron. We're about to get started for the third set soon. Don't go nowhere. Thank you. Welcome back. My name is Terrence Prevalon, and right next to me is Kenny Ciceron, color commentator. We are in the third set of this game versus Millar Edge Women's versus the Lady Bobcats. Looking to make something happen. The first set was 25-9, but Burman rallied back in the second set. Unfortunately, lost that one too. That was 25-23. But we see progress, don't we, Kenny?
Yeah, we do. We do. It was a close set. We had the lead. We made mental mistakes for us to lose that lead. So
right.
It was closer than the first set for sure.
Definitely. But, you know, we're off to a good start in the third set here.
Yeah, yeah.
Already put some points on the board. Here's Dana Ray looking to make something happen. Pushes it. Good serve. There. Oh, yeah. That counts. That's good.
We'll take that.
That's 2-0 for our Lady Bobcats. If we can string together a couple of points and just hold on to that lead, this would be very crucial.
Yeah.
It'd be quite demoralizing, you know, to go home without at least seeing one of our teams win a set here. Right?
Yeah, 1,000%. There you go.
And that's the great wall of Burman right there. Jessica Matthew making things happen. So Jarrell McMains, the coach of this volleyball team, is actually head dean, head administrative dean here at Birmingham University.
Is it official now?
At least interim.
Okay.
Interim, I believe, since the departure of Tammy Keller.
Yeah.
He stepped into that role.
Okay.
Out of seniority.
Yeah, it makes sense for sure.
Yes. For next year, we don't quite know, but it would make sense if it was him.
Yeah.
But yeah, he's fondly known as Dean Jarrell.
Yeah.
Or as little Prince would call him, you know, Jin Jarrell, like Dean Jarrell, you know?
The rapper.
Right. And there's Prince right there. I don't know if you can see him on the camera.
Not really.
Hey, Jockton, can you slide right there? There he is, right there. There you see.
Right there.
Thank you. But yeah, it's a tie game right now.
Yep.
Tie game right now. We're going to see which team, like, you know, breaks loose here.
Yep.
Here's a serve by Millar Edge. Oh, no. Can you track that one down? Right now, Millar Edge is looking to put some points on the board. Here's a serve. Great serve.
Good.
Great reception by Kimberly Lange. Jada Freeman getting up there to send that one back. And that is O-U-T.
Out.
Now we have Jessica Matthew looking to keep the momentum going for Burman. Great serve. Oh, and that's not going to clear it, unfortunately.
Good try, though.
Good effort, though.
Good try, though.
You know, that was a great reception by number 13, the liberal, Ethel Boha. No, sorry, folks, if I'm butchering anybody's name, but I think
it looks good to me.
Ethel Boha, you know. But yeah, Millar Edge definitely came to play from yesterday, Thursday.
Yeah.
This is, Donisha Cooper seems to lose the ball there.
Good hit.
Good serve received by Ethel Borja. Oh. And that's a good hit, but that is. Oh, yeah, that's in. That's good.
Look, captain again. Listen.
Peyton Reamer has had a great game today.
She's player of the game for Millar, for sure.
Yeah, for sure.
Show me where that game go.
If this were to end right now, yeah, she would definitely be player of the game for Millar. Good reception by Jessica Matthew. That's a set by Dana Ray.
There you go.
For Jada Freeman. Oh, she's fired up. You know what I'm saying? I think she's catching it. You know?
Yep, she is.
She's catching it, and she's about to go serve right now.
Reminds me of a Patrick Beverly, man. You know, with the energy.
Jada Freeman?
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, I can see it.
Yeah, you know? Always hyped up, man.
I love the basketball references, Kenny.
I appreciate that, man.
Great serve. And that's
look at that.
A reception by Ethel Boha, but there's nobody else to come get it.
She might go on a run by herself like she did the other round, you know?
Right,
the other
set. Yeah, she has a tendency to do that, right?
Yep. Called game changers, like game managers,
again.
You know?
Here we go again. Jada Freeman, the hit. Oh, yeah.
Like I said.
Oh, yeah.
She's game changers, game managers.
Tactician.
Yep.
She's choosing her spots, but I realize that she's always going for the right side. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
She's a right hitter, but she's always like, yeah, powering towards the right side. Let's see where she goes this time. Yeah, right side again. She has a set. Oh, no, that's no good. Can't do that. Jada Freeman just gave Burman
3 points.
3 points right there. Let's see if she can give some more. Little pre-serve routine. Oh. Ethel Borja knew exactly where that was going to go.
Yep.
Oh. Here we go. Crystal Matthew throws that one over. And Burman looking to get in position. And now it seems that Millar Edge is making the little mistakes. Yeah. Now, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, mental mistakes. But right. Honestly, we'll take those.
Yeah. Just want to acknowledge number one, Tash. Okay. Oak? Tash Oak? Oak? Okay. Sorry if I'm butchering anybody's names, but there she goes. One hit right there. Who just entered the game?
Amy?
That's a great set. Oh, great reception by our libero, Kimberly Lange. Oh, this is a great return right here. Yep. Here we go. Oh, and yeah, she definitely looked one way and did something else with it. I see two decoys right there. That's a set for Evie Magadaro, and that is too hard,
She was a little taller, man.
She was a little taller. These balls would be a little easier to control for her, for sure.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, better placement too.
Right, but you know the height works in her advantage. You know what I'm saying? Her height works into her advantage because it's deceptive. You know, you don't necessarily know what to expect, and she has more hops than you would think, right?
1,000%.
Oh, that one was beautiful by Ashley Volkman. I don't know what was better, the set or the spike.
Listen, both were masterclass.
Definitely.
That's what I know.
See, I don't remember who did that set, but I acknowledge you, miss.
Number seven.
Was that number seven?
No, the one who just served, yeah. Morgan.
That would be Morgan Unroe.
Yep.
Here's Emi Magdaro.
Yep.
Burman is up 11-8.
Mental mistake.
In slight control of this game, but it's a little back and forth now. You know what I'm saying? It's little mental mistakes that prevent both teams from actually, like, you know, being in full control of what's going on here. We are in the third set of this best of five series. Great reception by Jessica Matthew. She clears it over. It's another great reception by Ethel Borja.
Oh!
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you got to watch out for that one.
Careful.
Yeah, but she was eager. That's Peyton Reamer, captain of Millar Edge.
I appreciate the hustle.
100%, you know? Just trying to make something happen for her team, right? And Grace Felberg, coming in. We also have Donisha Cooper coming in. Oh, just gets to pass the net. Yeah, Here we go. This might be a good one. This might be a good one, folks. Oh, no. Unfortunately, she got under it, but couldn't control it there.
Mental mistake. We can't afford to have mental mistakes right now, man. We're down two sets.
Good serve. Oh, no. It's not going to get there. But, see, that's the advantage of having a good wingspan, you know?
Yep.
Dana Ray had nowhere to go with that, right?
She had no.
It's not really her fault, but, you know, that's a great heads-up play by Millar Edge. That one is out. See, Burman is being gifted, you know, being gifted a couple of, free points by some mental mistakes by Millar Edge.
Yeah.
But at this point, you know, you don't take what they gave you, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because what if they give you nothing, right? You got to create for yourself.
Agreed. Ooh, good low serve.
Oh, yeah. That was a little hard to control.
It was.
But Tash, okay. But Millar gets the point anyway.
You got to communicate.
And I think it's important to note the crowd here for Millar Edge. As you can see on the opposite side, right behind the ref, that's mostly Millar supporters.
I think it's all Millar supporters.
Yeah. Here's a set for Jessica Matthew, who just finessed her. Uh-oh. See, that's good. That's good. That's exactly what you need.
Thank
and
you,
I think Jessica Matthew right there is about to go serve.
Yep. She served far.
Good hit.
Good hit.
It's a good set by.
There you go. Our point. No.
No.
She didn't hit it?
Yeah, I saw the trajectory of that. Yeah, she got up for it, but like I said, you know, if she was a little taller, you know, it'd be easier to control, right?
I thought Miller Edge hit it, to be honest.
You thought it was a deflection?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Fortunately not. See, it's like I said, you know, it's back and forth because of little mental mistakes, right?
Yep.
But yeah, we'll see how this goes. So Donisha Cooper gets a chance to serve here. That's in. Here's the serve by okay. Here's the wall. Oh no. There's miscommunication there. I think Imi Magadaro was calling. Clear. We're good, right? And everybody cleared it, but definitely that's not what needed to happen, of course. Currently the score is 15-14. Those who are just tuning in, my name is Terrence Prevalon. Right next to me is Kenny Cicerone, color commentator.
Yep.
Burman is in control right now.
Right now,
it seems that the score is tied.
Evened up,
right? We are currently in the most crucial stages where this game can flip in any direction right now.
Yep.
You know? And Burman needs to find it within themselves to make something happen. Oh. Oh, no.
Another mental mistake.
It's okay, though. You know, like, at this point, nothing's set in stone, right?
Yeah.
Powerful spike by Ashley Volkman, number 14 of Millar Edge. The score is 17-15 for Millar Edge. Currently, Burman is trying to find a way to stay into this game. Oh, and that's a great reception by Imi Magadaro. Hit by Grace Feldberg. Oh, yeah. That one, if they can get it out, that'd be in their advantage. Burman can easily do something with this here. Jessica Matthew hits it. All right, we're just going back and forth. Here's a set now. Oh. That's saved by Dana Ray. Here is Millar on the retaliation. And, yeah, she hit the net there, definitely. Some points for Burman. Crowd is a little nervous right now.
Yeah.
Folks, listen, we're in the final stages of this set right here. And that was that's a powerful hit. And that's a hit by Ashley Volkman, who's really coming in the clutch right now. Did you know, Kenny, that the coach for Millar Edge is actually the athletic director for their programs?
Is he?
Yeah, he is.
I didn't know that. I thought it was Peters, right? That's his name? The last coach on the team.
Kevin Peters? No, yeah. Kevin Peters is he is the coach for the volleyball team.
Oh.
Right? But I'm sorry, his name is actually escaping me right now, but it is that gentleman that you see pacing right there. Yes, he is actually their AD.
I did not know that.
Yeah. Millar and Burman are actually very similar in terms of, like, you know, how we just operate and how, like, many people play different roles. Oh, and unfortunately, that's another point for Millar Edge. See, there's a song that Kendrick Lamar and Mary J. Blige sing that I love very much, and it's called Now or Never.
Yep.
And it's really Now or Never for the Lady Bobcats.
To make a run.
Right? It's seeming more like never than now. And it seemed like now more than never for the Millar Edge team right here. Here's one running serve. Received. Set for Jessica Matthews. She's asking for it. Oh, that's saved by it. Oh, yeah. She wanted it. She asked for it. She got it. She made it happen.
Yep.
Here's Donisha Cooper back into the game right now, looking for some offensive strategies by Jarrell McMaines. Great composure. Oh, no.
Mental mistakes
by Grace Feldberg. It's okay, though, you know? It's okay. And as you can see, her teammates are not too shaken about it, you know. On to the next, right? Serve.
We'll take that.
Yep. What do they say? Well, don't lie.
Oh, man.
A little technical difficulties with the ball there. Here's Dana Ray, who was actually the first server up today.
Yeah.
That's a good serve. Is that Ashley Volkman? Number 14. Is that number 14? Oh, no, that's number five.
Maddie.
Maddie Bodker, yes. Here's the serve, and that's out. Great communication.
Yep.
Great communication. It's not over till it's over, you know?
Yep.
Crowd is anxious, nervous here. Here's Jessica Matthew. Ooh. Clears that one. Oh, no.
That's a mistake.
See, I'm a little nervous myself.
I am too.
Butterflies and everything, you know? This is a far serve. Runs into it. And that's out.
Thank you.
You see, Millar, honestly, like, you know, that could have been the game for them right there, you know?
And
honestly, it can come back them.
It could
come haunt them later. Let's see if we'll make them pay. Here's Donisha Cooper. Serve. Yep. Does that. Out. Oh. Yes. Oh. Right. Donisha Cooper has a chance to win this for Burman. I said, it's now or never.
Yep.
Right? There can't be no mistakes here. Right? She's serving from a different side now.
Ooh.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Yeah, she's beating herself up for that one. You know what?
It's a tough one.
It's fine, though. It's fine.
It's a tough way to lose, man.
That is a tough way to lose, you know? And as an athlete, you know, that's not how you want to go out, you know?
Yeah.
Game on the line, and it's in your hands, you know what I'm saying? Everybody dreams about glory, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And it didn't happen there, but you can't beat yourself up for that one,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
You got to look at that and just grow from it, right? Because when you're at the bottom, there's only one place to go.
Top.
Up, exactly, you know? Final score, 25-22 for the last set. The sets were 25-9, 25-3, and 25-22. 3-0 for Millar Edge and Burman U.
Yeah.
Disappointing couple games for the men and Lady Bobcats.
Yeah.
But like I said, when you're at the bottom, there's only one place to go.
The top. Yep.
So thank you for joining this broadcast. I think we're about to announce the player of the games for... the player of the game for this women's team.
Introducing your players of the game. Number 11, Peyton.
That is Peyton Rimmer. Well deserved.
Number 6,
Gamma Ray. Well deserved too. You know, she played a great game as a setter today, you know?
Yep.
So, any final thoughts before we leave our people today?
Yeah, good, entertaining game, close sets. We just couldn't finish it when we had to finish it. But like you said, when we're at the bottom, is the only way to go up. And it's the top.
It's the top, right?
Yeah.
Right. Definitely a disappointing outing, but we love the school spirit, and we love the fact that everybody showed out today.
Yep.
Thanks for those watching off of YouTube. You know, there'll be more games. Please tune into those.
Yep.
My name was Terrence Prevalon, and... Kenny Ciceron right next to me.
Yes, sir.
Shout out to everybody that made this game happen today.
Yes, sir.
Jockton, shout out to you, man. Man behind the camera.
Man behind the camera.
And,
man.
You know, we just want to say peace.
Yeah.
Can't see wait. Yeah. Hold on. We going. Yeah. There we go.
There you go.
All right. Peace.
Yes, sir.